Hello everyone, welcome back to PJ Chen Design Channel. Today we're gonna talk about this very popular Claddagh ring and the besetting on the side as a bracelet right there with the crown on the top. Are you ready? Let's get started. There are a few parts of the ring in this tutorial. First, we have the prong setting in the middle. You can find my stone setting video in the description that I have different type of a stone setting. Prong set is one of them, so we don't have to repeat that in this video. Then we're gonna create a prong and giving those milligram looking surface. Then is the hand part, and after that we're gonna creating this ring shank to blend it really well, and finally we're going to adding the besetting over there. First, you can find any of the graphic image or any of the image you would like to use. Pretty much this is going to be a reference, doesn't have to be exactly the same, but we're gonna put it up there just seeing the reference and the proportion. Then we want to go to the top view. We already have the setting over there. You can move it up a little bit or whatever position that you like. I would like to just trace over those line here, and I'm going to come over here and using the curve tool to simply to do something look like this. Okay, and I also have a box there, so that is the ending point for my line. After that, I'm going to simply just making into a closed curve by joining the curve together. So I have this to be joined, and then I'm going to mirror that to the other side. So let's go ahead to mirror it. All right, so it may not 100% match that, but that is okay because it's just a reference. Then after that, I'm going to use the second arc tool, starting in and point on the arc. We are going to do something like this. Okay, so that kind of give us a reference for what the crown is going to be. Then I'm simply just going to unlock my picture and hide it. So this is the crown that we have. I'm going to offset like 0.5 millimeters. So that is the area in between will be my bees aligned over there. Okay, I would like to have those foam extruded first for whatever how high that's going to be. So I'm going to have the extruded planar curve straight. Make sure double side equal yes, solid equal yes. And we don't want it higher than the stone, so we want to have something like this. Okay, in the middle part, I'm going to move it up a little bit, do the same thing with one side only, and so that way we can bowling difference that one out. So that's mirror that piece to the other side as well. Okay, so we simply just going bowling difference this one out of this one. All right, so they have a little bit depth over there. Okay, with this one, I'm going to creating the curve going down like this. It can be any as long as it's inside of the shape. Okay, and let's go ahead to join them and make sure I project it to construction plan. So for this one, we want to extrude it as well, but this time we want to extrude it just a little bit lower. So we do have a little bit definition there. So this will be what we have. Okay, so now I have a straight box inside as well. I want to make sure this is being extruded as well, and they want to extrude it the same size. Kind of notice that I have everything lowered in my setting because I will do the bowling difference later on. Just want to make sure that everything has enough to cut for my ring shank. Alright, so now we have something like this. We are going to arrange some beads on the top. So what I like to do is I'm gonna use the same curve. I was using 0.5 millimeter offset. This time I want to offset one more time just right in the middle, so 0.25. Then I will have that curve right in the middle. Let's put one B first. We're gonna have this B right here, and I'm just gonna put it something like this. And make sure the B is actually on the surface, so it's going to be something like this. And move it to the center just a little bit. You can make the B is exactly to the edge if that worked better for you, but we want to give it a try. We are going to the transform. Then you have the array along curve. We are going to pick up the object first. Enter, it will access the curve that we just created. I don't know how many do I need it, but I'm just gonna guess for 30 of them and see what does it look like. All right, if this is too close to you, we may wanna redo it and using last B. Let's try one more time. Array along the curve. This is the object, enter, and this is our curve. And we want to record history, and let's say 20 of them. All right, so what is a good thing about record history is you can kind of moving the beads, arrange them if they are not in the position that you like. Okay, so once we have those beads, I'm just going to mirror to the other side. So let's go ahead to use the mirror and then holding the shift. So you have it, the beads on the other side. Now with this one, I'm trying to create another bead. So I'm just gonna grab one of the beads over here. And then let me use the same command. We're gonna array along the curve. So this is the object going to array. And this is the curve. I'm picking up the edge right here. So I'm kind of guessing it might be only 6 of them. And let's take a look. So it looks okay to me. And I'm going to make sure that I pick up all of them and move it a little bit lower because our second one is actually, the middle one is actually a little bit lower. All right, so we kind of finished the top part. If you don't like it, you can keep continuing to edit it. And I'm going to move everybody closer a little bit to the center. All right, so now we finished the top crown part. We are going to create with the ring size diameter for 16, radius for 8. And then we are going to move everything up somewhere around there. So as you can see, we want to make sure that when the metal is cutting, we have enough for the setting and also the crown, so that way it will be flush for the inside of a ring shank. All right, so we'll cut that later, but now we wanted to do is the hand. Let's bring in the picture one more time. The hand roughly look like this. So I'm going to use the command for the sphere and kind of creating a sphere roughly about this size. Okay, and then kind of bringing in and shape it, changing the angle if you like it. All right, so this is not gonna be a realistic hand, but it will serve its purpose. And then we wanna move this hands up, something like this. Okay, so first things we wanted to do is we need to cut this area open. I'm just gonna draw a line, simply looking something like this. All right, see, the second line I'm going to have is I'm going to follow this drawing to come out something like this. And again, you can find this drawing easy online. There are a lot of graphic you can use for the reference. Doesn't have to make them exactly the same, it's just proportion reference. Okay, so now I have all this line. For this one specifically, I do want them to be a closed curve, so I want to make sure that it is closed there and make sure I join them. Okay, so for this one, I don't know if I snapping weird like I did. So to fix this issue, let's go to project to construction plan, and we want to delete the input. All right, so very basically, I'm just going to extrude that into the solid form. So extrude planar curve straight, something like this, and we simply just going to do the bowling difference. So to cut that open. The second one that we have, I'm going to pick up those curve and project it to this hand. So now I have the curve on it look like this. I'm simply, it's going to pipe them. So let's go ahead to giving a small pipe in the diameter about 0.2. Okay, so we are going to use bowling difference. This will be out of those piping. So kind of give us a groove to work on it. Okay, so now we have something like this. We can just simply to mirror to the other side. If you feel like the contact right here is too small, you may want to move in the hand a little bit so you will have a better contact there. Okay, so that's mirror to the other side. So now we have the hand ready. Let's go ahead to making the ring shank. All right, for the ring shank, I no longer need this picture, so let's go ahead to hide it. And I know you're gonna say this is like kind of weird, a big two blob over there, but we're gonna trim it off later. All right, so I'm going to creating an arc. It's going to be something like this, and join them together. I also want to have a round corner so it's more comfortable. Let's try 0.2, and it's working okay there. I'm going to have this one to mirror to the other side. So now we have the ring shank there. So let me go ahead to use the rotate tool and copy equal yes. We want to copy one on the top. So now with this curve right here, I just need to make them a little bit bigger. So we are going to use 3D scale. We're gonna scale it up a little bit. Right, so now we have something like this. Let's give it a try. Let's do sweep one rail. Before we sweep, we want to record the history. This is the rail, this is the cross section. Make sure that you have all the arrows aligned in the inside of ring shank, and make sure you close the sweep. We want to bring out our design over there. Apparently this is like way too big, so it's bigger than my hand. So what I'm going to do is we need to make that piece smaller. We can scale this down a little bit so that will fit better over there. All right, so let me turn on this. Everything looking pretty good here. But the connection, if we're looking at the rendering, it's going to be pretty ugly there. So what I like to do is we need to creating a blending surface over there. Let's go ahead to use the bowling split and split this out from this one and this one. And then we don't need anything in the middle. So we are going to delete this guy here. Okay, so now we have two parts right here. We can go ahead to bowling them. And all we need to do now is giving a fillet edges. So let me try 0.7. All right, so we can get a very smooth looking surface right there. We're gonna do the same thing on the other side. Okay, so now everything is almost set over there. We wanted to make sure everything is correct. So let's go ahead to using the ring curve that we have. And that's using the solid extruded planar curve stray. Make sure you cover everything. So we're going to do a bunch of a bowling difference. Let's go ahead to bowling difference. The hand, the crown, the setting. And don't forget that little block that we have right in the middle. And then that's the first set. The second set is the cylinder. So now we have everything here. Double make sure that this is right at the correct position. All right, so let's take a look on the render view. Now coming to the front view, I would like to draw a curve like this and project this curve to this surface. All right, so then I will get a curve cross there. This curve is going to help me to creating the setting. I'm bringing the stone for 0.8 millimeter. If you want to know how to make stone, you can check out my video in the description below. And I also have, it's going to creating a curve. It's about this long, and this is going to be our prong. So let me go ahead to pipe it. We are going to pipe with the small prong size, approximately like this. And I'm having the prong and mirror to the other side. So this is gonna be one set of it. Simply, I'm just gonna group them so I don't have to click so many times. Let's put this one right there, and we are going to flow over to the other side. Let's go ahead to break this curve. We don't need a button, straight one. We're going to transform array along the curve, and we're gonna pick up this object and pick up this curve. I'm guessing 7 of them, and let's see how it goes. It's pretty good. All right, we have done some adjustment, and you can have, once you like your adjustment, then you can have them mirror to the other side. Okay, so that will be our clad ring today. I hope you enjoyed the video. Please like and comment, and let me know if you have other things that you would like to see in the video. Thank you, and I'll see you next time.